ultimate cupcakes. Pinkie Pie took the unfrosted cupcakes out from the oven after adding only the minimum amount of ingredients needed. She started baking ever since she woke up, and she had plans on making a special dessert that will make her friends aesthetic once the taste buds react to it upon consumption. As she placed the 10 cupcakes on the counter, Mrs. Cake came into the kitchen. "Pinkie Pie," she asked, "have you been indoors all day?" "Yes, Zoe," Pinkie smiled while looking at her cookbook. Mrs. Cake looked at the desserts Pinkie made in the process. "You spent the whole day making a batch of 10 cupcakes? I thought they didn't take that time to make." As Pinkie Pie placed 6 colored frosting packages on the counter, she wraps her hoof around Mrs. Cake's neck. "There's more love in the treat if you spent more time making them," she smiled. "These cupcakes have almost all the ingredients mashed together in the most minimum sizes I could add." Mrs. Cake looked at the cupcakes herself. "So, what kind of ingredients did you add?" "Strawberries, blueberries, bananas, cherry, and so many other fresh fruits I can't recall them all, but I still add them in nonetheless." Mrs. Cake is speechless on how many ingredients Pinkie just added into a batch of cupcakes. "Is that it? That's not even half of what I added," Pinkie squealed while showing the list of ingredients to Mrs. Cake. "As for sweets, I added mint, caramel, butterscotch, vanilla, chocolate, Nutella, and nearly all the most popular sweets I could find," she jumped in the air. Mrs. Cake couldn't even believe what she just heard from Pinkie Pie. No one in all the lands of Equestria would ever make a cupcake with that many ingredients, ranging from fruits to sweets. But in all of her curiosities, she still had one question. "What were the main ingredients you added?" "Simple, love and magic," Pinkie lifted her hoof up. "We all know that love takes hours to make it happen, but with the addition of magical sparkles, my friends will never taste cupcakes in the same way again." She let go of Mrs. Cake as she proceeded to frost with one of the 6 colors of each cupcake. "And with the addition of rainbow frosting, it will be better than perfection." The light blue pony felt unsure with the party pony's cupcakes. "Pinkie Pie," she sighed, which causes Pinkie's ear to perk up while still frosting the cupcakes. "I've been teaching you how to make cupcakes since I allowed you to stay at Sugar Cube Corner." "Yep, and I've improved so much. But don't you think this is a bit too much for your friends to handle? I'm sure one of them won't like some of the ingredients in those," she pointed at the cupcakes. "How's that an issue?" Pinkie smiled while adding orange frosting. "Because they're not into all the foods they've eaten while they were growing up. Not only that, but these cupcakes are too unstable." Just before Pinkie was about to add yellow frosting, she stopped herself. "I think the right word you're supposed to say is unhealthy." "Yes, but that's not the point. I don't know how you managed to add magic into desserts, but with love as well, I don't think fillies will control themselves when they eat those. I suggest that after you're done with the frosting, you should cut them in half." Pinkie looked at her cupcakes after listening to Mrs. Cake's advice. When she looked at a list of ingredients, she spent so many hours baking those cupcakes after a week of getting everything on the list. Not only that, the cupcakes are in medium size instead of small. "I guess you're right. These aren't anything close to similar compared to what I've made after years of baking." "Yes, and I will say that making something new is always the next step." Pinkie teared up after hearing that helpful and kind gesture from Mrs. Cake. "Thanks. I still can't wait for my friends to eat these." As she continued to frost the cupcakes, Mrs. Cake left the kitchen. "I'm still unsure about this," she said to herself as she looked at Pinkie Pie one more time until she rolled her eyes. Her friends will have the most unstable desserts in the history of our bakery. In Ponyvale, Twilight along with her friends are trying to find their hyperactive party friend after hours of searching. "Don't you think Pinkie isn't around because she's busy or something?" Flusheye asked. "It's Monday, Flusheye," Twilight replied from the front. "While we do our daily work, Pinkie does other activities because Monday is her favorite day of the week." "Same goes for Friday, darling," Royalty added. "But still, isn't she supposed to meet with us if it's Monday?" Starlight wondered. I don't know, but I think it's best if we see what she's been doing this whole time, Spike recalled. She must be at Sugar Coop Corner, right? Applejack asked. That's where we're going then, Rainbow Dash finished. After walking through town, they saw Sugar Coop Corner where the party pony friend must be at. While a friend's way outside, the Princess of Friendship headed inside the bakery with Mrs. Cake waiting at the corner. Twilight, Mrs. Cake smiled. Is Pinkie Pie here? She asked, which made Mrs. Cake roll her eyes, still unsure. She's in the kitchen making cupcakes. Cupcakes? She spent the whole day making cupcakes? This may be hard to believe, but yes. Silence permitted the interior of the bakery. Just when Twilight was suspecting a rhetorical answer, her question was actually true. Then, at just the right time, Pinkie came out of the kitchen with a rainbow box on her back. Twilight, you're here, she cheered. Pinkie Pie, Twilight lowered her eyes. Did any pony help you make those cupcakes? She pointed at the box. Nope, I made them all by myself, and it's for you and the others. Twilight became speechless as she looked at the cupcake box herself. She knew how much cupcakes mean to Pinkie, so it never feels unusual. Okay, so do you want me and the others to try some of your cupcakes? Definitely. Just before Pinkie opened the box, Mrs. Cake stopped her. How about you have some outside of my bakery, she offered. Trust me, it's the best choice. Okay, this feels odd, Twilight making a confused look. She and Pinkie head outside of Sugar Coop Corner with Mrs. Cake right behind them. Pinkie Pie, Flush Eye spoke. You spend all your time inside the bakery? Applejack asked. She was making, let's just say, a special kind of cupcakes, Mrs. Cake replied. Pinkie Pie opened the rainbow box and revealed the cupcakes to her friends. Despite the cupcakes being sliced in half, the rainbow frosting caught their attention, not to mention the craving for cupcakes. But what they don't know is what their friend put in those cupcakes. Well, these cupcakes look positively delightful, Rarity commented. Yeah, they have the same colors of my mane, Rainbow exclaimed as she flew over the box. I gotta say, Pinkie, these look promising, Twilight added. Perfect, Pinkie squealed. I was thinking one of you should take a slice and eat it. Fine by us, Starlight smiled. She used her telekinesis and took out half of the cupcake from the box. Once she saw the core, it felt unusual with different kinds of fruits and sweets close together. Pinkie, have you been adding as many ingredients as possible to these cupcakes? Yep. Maybe these aren't right to eat, Flush Eye said, looking at Starlight's cupcake. That wasn't until Pinkie got on her knees. Come on, please try them. I put a lot of effort into them. I know it's hard to believe, but it's always true once you eat it, Mrs. Cake said, while still aware of what could happen soon with Twilight and her friends. Starlight looked at the light blue eyes from Pinkie Pie and she's desperate for her to eat her cupcake. You really want us to try these? She asked. So much. I made these for my best friends in Equestria, Pinkie replied. Starlight sighed to herself as she looked at the cupcake half. Alright, I'll give it a bite. Pinkie put all her attention on her first cupcake taster with a huge smile on her face. After Starlight opened her mouth, she put the whole cupcake inside. However, before she could chew it, the taste from the cupcake on her tongue caused her to start vibrating. Out of all the cupcakes she got from Pinkie, this wasn't anything like she expected. Starlight, Twilight asked, you should swallow it now. After hearing a friend, Starlight swallowed the cupcake, which leads to the unexpected. So, how is it? Pinkie blinked several times. It was great, but I thought it would be not good, Starlight replied while feeling something inside her body. Then sparkles came to emanate from her body, which caused her friends to back away slightly. Starlight, are you feeling alright? Spike added. I don't know what's happening to me, Starlight struggling. A horn started to shoot lasers, and I have no feeling of control of my horn. Incoming! Applejack shouted as she ducked to the ground. The beams from Starlight Torn continued to cause havoc in Ponyville with the citizens ducking for cover. What did you put in those cupcakes? Rainbow reacted. The next laser from Starlight hit the window and straight back at her. It caused her to be paralyzed along with her horn. She moans with her whole body still feeling the effects of the unstable magic as if eating the cupcake caused a draining side effect. I think I need to be at Twilight's castle until it wears off, she replied. I can move slightly, but I don't think I can go much faster. Twilight, being one of Starlight's closest friends, used her teleportation spell and took Starlight to her castle while she can be on lockdown. That's one down, Mrs. Cake thought while the Princess of Friendship teleported back. Pinkie Pie, are you sure these cupcakes are safe? Twilight asked. Yeah, I mean, Starlight can't even move on her own now, Rarity added. Come on, you can tell her home was excited by shooting beams of happiness, Pinkie jumped. Yeah, beams of being stopped in place, Applejack retorted as she looked at the half-sliced cupcakes that are still in the box. But in all seriousness, your biggin' seals were always harmless, so I doubt nothing bad will happen to me. Perfect, Pinkie cheered as she gave her country girlfriend the cupcake half. You're always the most honest when it comes to sweets. What can I say, we're both pros at making desserts. After Applejack picked up her cupcake, she ate it and once she tasted, it was phenomenal from her view. While tasting the foods she's familiar with during her yard walk back at Sweet Apple Acres, her hooves began to shake, which made her party friend thrilled. Yes, I knew you would love it, she cheered. How is it, darling? Rarity asked. It's so amazing, I will never taste cupcakes the same way again. Applejack smiled with excitement in her ears. With a sugar rush in her legs, she desperately wants to kick something from behind. She lifted her back hooves up and kicked the sign behind her, but unexpected, she launched the sign into the sky. Applejack, Spike reacted upon seeing the sign she kicked. Do you just launch our open and closed sign a huge distance? Mrs. Cake said in disbelief. The country pony opened her eyes and turned around, with no sign behind her. Did I really just... She looked at the sky and saw the sign landing in the forest. I really did. There was no way you would be able to kick an object that hard, Rainbow commented. Applejack became speechless from what she could weigh. After adoring the cupcake, she thought it wouldn't affect her. She has the strength of kicking something extremely hard. I think I've become like my brother, except I have the powers of a power pony now. Can you please get our sign? Mrs. Cake asked, placing her hoof on her face. That's our only open and closed sign. Alright, but once I return it, I might need to stay at my place for a while. Applejack left her friends as she head to the forest to retrieve the object she kicked away. That's two. So, who wants another cupcake? Pinkie taking out another half-sliced cupcake from a box. Her friends feel unsure about taking a bite from Pinkie's overbaked dessert. Did you even try one for yourself? Spike asked. Nope, so I figure having my friends try out would be the best friendship idea. Yeah, Twilight makes an awkward smile, refusing to judge the cupcakes without tasting them. I'll give them a try, Flush, I being the next to test Pinkie's desserts. Hopefully, they're not unstable when I try them. And there goes three, Mrs. Cake rolled her eyes. As Pinkie Pie handed a cupcake half to Flush Eye took a bite of it. With her taste buds feeling the ingredients, it was the best cupcake she ever had. Her eyes sparkled in pure amazement, with her friends being surprised from her reaction, especially Pinkie. So, how was it? Pinkie asked. Flush Eye didn't say a word after she swallowed the cupcake. Her body felt like a completely different creature, like the animals she took good care of. She hung her tongue out and started panting like a thirsty puppy. Flush Eye? Rainbow Dash being wheeled out from her Pegasus friend. Are you feeling okay? I don't think she can understand us, Spike backing away. Fashai then sat on the ground while barking happily, which confuses our friends even more. Did your cupcakes turn Fashai into a dog? Twilight asked. Fashai then rushed to the other ponies and licked their faces as she jumped on top of them. I think they did, Mrs. Cake answered. Pinkie Pie couldn't be any happy to see her friends feel so different yet thrilled upon trying her cupcakes. With only four of her friends waiting, she can't delay the moment any longer. Well, tea, Pinkie popping up by the fashionista. I bet your critics of fashion would love to try these cupcakes for free samples. Well, there won't be samples unless I try them out, darling, Well, tea giggled. She took out another half-sliced cupcake with her telekinesis and took a bite out of it. The taste from her mouth couldn't taste the mundos of the rainbow frosted cupcake or the sweets she loves the most. Oh my, you like it? I love it, the fashionista wrapped her hooves around Pinkie Pie. In all my years, you made the miracle of our cupcakes. Well, looks like she knows how to judge a cupcake without anything odd happening, Spike commented. After Royalty broke the hug, she looked at the cupcakes from the box. I can't wait for the critics to try- What? She then begins to notice her mane grew longer. What's happening? Your mane is growing faster. That's what I'm seeing, Rainbow replied. And that's four down, Mrs. Cake thought again. The purple curvy mane stopped leaving Royalty in compelled shock. Look at me! I never want this mane to be this thick. This is embarrassing. Come on, once the critics see you, they would see you as one of the fanciest ponies in Ponyville, Pinkie chilled. I wouldn't be sure about that, Mrs. Cake commented. Oh no, that's not going to happen. I have to get a mane cut. Royalty rushed to a boutique with her friends still staring at her. But what about the samples? Pinkie shouted. I don't think she needs any samples now, Spike answered. The Princess of Friendship looked at the cupcakes herself after seeing her friends dealing with some side effects. Pinkie, I'm not sure if I'm going to eat these now that I'm aware of what happens afterwards. But Twilight, it took me all day to bake these. Pinkie lowered her ears. That's probably the reason why her friends are having side effects. Yeah, I doubt it would make any difference now, Rainbow added. But I want you two to have them. The party animal pony refuses to let her two best friends leave her without tasting the cupcakes. Twilight, on the other hand, wanted to do the right thing, but the odds of harming Pinkie Pie is always easy. She sighed while lowering her ears. Alright, I'll give them a try. It made Pinkie Pie feel a little better to know the Princess of Friendship wouldn't try out her cupcakes. Once Twilight used her telekinesis to lift yet another slice cupcake from the box, she places it in her mouth and eats it. Upon tasting it, she can analyze the ingredients from what her friend put in. Her taste buds can feel almost everything sweet and fruit to the point it couldn't reach any limits. Soon her hooves began to shake with strong flavors from her mouth, picking up the better taste. Oh, don't tell me she's gonna explode, Rainbow Dash looking at the princess's face. Then, after almost 10 seconds, Twilight grew a smile with her eyes wide open. Aw, isn't the fillies in the cluster so cute and sweet? She squealed. What are you talking about? Spike blinked with Twilight leaning closer to him. I'm talking about how the lovely fawls who are so appreciative with each other. It's the sweetest thing any pony does. She closed her eyes while wrapping the hooves around herself. I just want to hug one so much. You don't usually do that, Mrs. Cake responded. Why, they deserve a hug from my gesture of magic. Twilight then went on her own so she can find a fall to hug. Okay, I'm being serious. What did you put in those cupcakes? Rainbow looking at Twilight's sweetheart attitude. Love, and most importantly, magic, Pinkie jumped. Well, that explains everything, Spike looking at Twilight searching for flowers. Rainbow knew she would be the last pony to eat the cupcakes from Pinkie. However, she's worried if something happens to her. Same goes her friends. But at the same time, she will regret it if she declines. Pinkie, Rainbow looking at the sky. Give me a cupcake so I can get this over with. Okie dokie, Loki. Pinky handed yet another sliced cupcake to her friends. Once Rainbow Dash eats the cupcake herself, she takes her time swallowing it while tasting all the flavors. As much as she likes Pinkie Pie's cupcakes, she barely adores it as much as other ponies do. However, her taste buds still couldn't resist the amount of flavors going on at once. After pushing it down in her stomach, she closed her eyes, preparing the unexpected, but as it turns out, nothing happened. When she opened her eyes, she looked at both of her hooves, including her wings, and she felt nothing at all. "Are you feeling anything?" Mrs. Cake responded. "Not really. I don't think anything is affecting me," Rainbow replied. "Well, that's a relief," Spike said. "How was the cupcake?" Pinky wondered. "It was great, although it didn't need to be so sweet much," Rainbow recalled. "But at least I don't have to worry about any side effects. I'm gonna head home now." Just before she lifted herself off from the ground, a huge boom caught Spike, Pinky, and Mrs. Cake unnoticed as they fell to the ground. Rainbow flew with so much speed, she can't even stop herself. "My goodness," Mrs. Cake reacted. Spike didn't think cupcakes would make her friends deal with some serious side effects that would be dangerous than he thought. "Pinky, I don't want a cupcake, and that's my final choice. But Spike, even dragons deserve desserts like my best friends." Unfortunately, the dragon continues to back away. "Sorry, but I don't want to take the risk of having a side effect. I'm going to get Zecora to help." "But Spike..." "Just let him go," Mrs. Cake shouted, allowing the dragon to head to Everfree Forest. After seeing Pinky's friends into psychotic situations, she saw quite enough. "Can you see what I'm talking about?" Pinky took the time to listen while looking at the 7 cupcakes in her box. "As much as I like the effort, it's still too much for the wrong reasons. Now your friends are dealing with side effects that could be temporary or permanent to themselves." Pinkie Pie felt disappointed in herself. All she ever wanted is to give her friends something she worked very hard at, but end up giving them side effects. Something no friend should ever do. "I think I spent the whole day wasting my time on the worst cupcakes of all time," she cried. "If you didn't add magic to those cupcakes, maybe they wouldn't be so bad in a good way." Mrs. Cake walks up to Pinky while trying to make her feel better. "At least you finally know the biggest setback of all of this." After thinking about her mistakes, Pinkie Pie gave the cupcake box to her. "Alright, from now on, I'm sticking back to normal cupcakes, the way it should be. Now that's what I like to hear from a baker," Mrs. Cake smiled. "You should head inside and rest for the day. But what about my friends? Spike has everything under control. Besides, you've done enough." As much as Pinky wants to fix her mistakes, she had a long day making cupcakes that are too much to handle. She decides to leave inside Sugar Cube Corner with Mrs. Cake to take the rest of the day off while her friends regain their own selves. Meanwhile, Twice Sparkle is hugging a filly with his hooves off the ground. She kept the hug longer since she met him, with the side effects still taking full control. "Aren't you gonna let me go?" Tindletop's feeling a bit uncomfortable in the position he's in. "No," Twilight squealed. "You're so cute, sweet, and once you get older, you'll become a very handsome, famous cult." Despite staying with the Princess of Friendship for a little longer, he liked hearing her somewhat honest words. "As much as I feel more creeped out by this, I hope she's a sidekick." Let's get this started again, again, again. Me and my home.